so that the common man can understand, intellectuals can understand. Even Krishna ji, the earlier writings as to my master. So we can see the outpourings of love and veneration, master. At the feet of the master also gives an ample testimony for that. To Krishna ji, love, process, the other, the being, the emptiness, the fullness, the compassion, the consciousness, love, beauty, and everything in the same. He has reached such an advanced stage wherein he has already gone beyond what you may call higher mind. There's a beautiful book written by Nandini Satpathy. I would request you people to read that if you have not gone through it. It is available, what you call, Soumitra Das of Cuttack will be able to present you the book or send you the book. What happens is, I am at the foot of the Himalayas. I can speak anything authentically about Mount Everest. So people who have gone beyond the pair of opposites, beyond physical body, astral body, mental body, lower mental body, higher mental body, who have reached the atmic level and beyond that, to them, there is no need for. But for we people, we require some guidance. And also Krishna ji used to say, believe in the teachings, forget the teacher. Gurus also say, satyam vada dharmam chara, swadhyaya anna pramadi devyam. So what happened, the teaching is much more important. Why Krishna ji may say like this? Because there's a preponderance of so many people calling themselves as gurus. In Guru Gita, it is stated, Jnana hino gurus tyajyo, mithyavadi vidambaka, swadishrantim na janadi, parashantim karodikim, pakhantinaha, pavrataha, nastikaha, veda buddhyaha, stri lambada, durachaaraha, kritaknaha, dagavrutyaha. Can you hear, sir? Hello? Am I audible? A person, a self-styled person, a preceptor who parades himself as teacher, who has absolutely no divine wisdom, who tells and lives on lies, who praises about him most, who is not in a position to be at peace with him or remain calm and graceful within him, how can he give peace and bliss to others? Now, such a person who parades as teacher should always be left out. He should not be approached. Pakhandinaha, pavarataha, nastikaha, bheda buddhayaha, stri lambadaha, durachaaraha, kritaknaha, bhagavirtaha. There are other pseudo-gurus who have no faith, who always indulges in sinful activities, who never believes in the ultimate divinity, who tries to create difference between one another, different sects, different kinds of people, who are always after women, and whose conduct and character are terrible, awesome, and who are ungrateful, and who are just like the beggars or the stuff. Such teachers are to be shunned. Especially in the present day, there's a preponderance of such so-called teachers or gurus who just to fill their bellies, just to get bigger states and ornaments and get a social standing, completely forget their ultimate aim in life, their goal, their spiritual efforts. They indulge in much more heinous activities than any layman would do. Such kinds of teachers, the so-called teachers, pseudo teachers, charlatans are to be removed. The teachings given to us by teachers. What should be our approach? Ultimately, we have to find out the teacher within ourselves. That will come at the end of how many genmas we are going to do it. But till that date, sacred books like Sacred Doctrine, Gita, Sri Aurobindo's work, Integral Yoga, Synthesis Yoga, Ramana Maharshi's teachings, J.K.'s works, and theosophical works, all these things are our teachers, but they are outsiders. Teacher in the teachings outside ourselves, then we have to turn within to touch the teaching by our obedience to the commands of truth. A loyal sense to the teacher and willing obedience to the behest of truth once we have placed our confidence in. You do not know the teacher, but there are great teachers. They are asked to have willing obedience to the behest of truth. Then how do we know? Touch the truth. We turn to within to test the teaching by our obedience to the commands of truth. Loyal to the inner vision, we find the horizons of our knowing for our expanding. Then the deep within you, call the deep within you, and you want to approach inwardly the sole purpose of realizing the truth, we find the horizons of our knowing ever expanding. Discovering that what happened to be a teacher without is actually the true teacher within. Sarvabhutatma, Paramatma. Your own highest spiritual self, as and when you progress and progress, will be your teacher. But it is not so easy. Every experience, every teaching should be tested at the altar of your conscience. Not ordinary conscience, but higher conscience. We find the horizons of our knowing for our expanding, discovering that what appeared to be a teacher without is actually our true teacher within. For there is but one teacher. Ultimate teacher, the Brahma Satya, the Brahma, the one being, the one consciousness, the one life, the supreme Atman in which abides all truth. It is to that teacher we pledge our duty. So when we repeat a loyal sense of to the teacher, we are committing ourselves to the best within, the supreme Atman in which abides all truth. It is to that teacher we pledge our duty, as it is to that truth be our willing assent. So, when you take a pledge, when you bow, dasaya me guru, tam asridoham, I have sought refuge in you, I go by your teachings, then actually the commitment is to our own self. There is but one teacher, the supreme Atman in which abides all the truth. To that teacher we pledge our duty. As it is to that truth we give our willing assent.
Follow the notification on your phone to turn on notification access.
lead the life and you will come to the wisdom. He has been ever the teacher of all genuine schools of occultism. Lead the life and we will come to the wisdom. That has been ever the dictum of all genuine schools of occultism or spirituality. Lead the life, don't exist. Perhaps a clue has been given in a simple statement found in the Mahatma letters. It matters little who wrote this verse. The Master Kailash or Yam or Chela, for they carry the authentic ring of truth. He stated, I can come nearer to you, I can come near to you, but you must draw me by a purified heart and a gradually developing will, like the needle adept follows the attractor. This is from Mahatma letter 47, chronology section. Whether the eye of the statement in the Mahatma letters, he is an external Mahatma or the higher self of each genuine aspirant, the Atman teacher abiding in the heart is less important than the simple requirements for coming to the truth. He is having the requirements given in all ages for the one who would know who is the teacher. A pure heart, a heart aflame with love and compassion, and a will that is born of a steadiness of purpose, a faithfulness to duty, a will that is never daunted by either failure or success, serene in the midst of circumstances, carrying us ultimately to the realization of the supreme truth, where teaching, teacher, and taught are one. See, when we practice like that, day by day, moment to moment, subjecting ourselves to crucial examination, and then move step by step, we fulfill the requirements with a pure heart, and a heart aflame with love and compassion, and a will that is born of a steadiness of purpose and a faithfulness to duty, the will that is never daunted by either failure or success, serene amid all circumstances, carrying us ultimately to the realization of the supreme truth, where teaching, teacher, and taught become one. So, we have to understand the concept of Guru, the reality of Guru, in such a way and proceed in our inward journey, so that today or tomorrow, in this life or next life, we become one with the Guru, become one with the eternal truth. You won't become a eternal bliss. That is from separate Atman, Sarva Bhut Atman. You become the Atman the great, and become the Paramatman the great, and then and in the end, we meet Akhanda Mandala Kaha. Let me remember that. Om Namah Shivaya Gurave Satchidananda Murtaye Nishprapanchaya Shantaya Niralambaya Tejase. Om Namah Shivaya Gurave Satchidananda Murtaye Nishprapanchaya Shantaya Niralambaya Tejase. Let us pray our reverential obeisance, namaskars, prostration to Shiva, with the preceptor of the preceptors, with the Adi Guru, with the embodiment of Satchidananda, being conscious and bliss, Nishpravinchaya, who is having no world, but at the same he got all the world. Shantaya, who is the quintessence of all bliss, Shanti. Niralambaya, who is the support of everybody, but he does not want any support. And Tejasa, the white light. Om Namah Shivaya Gurave Satchidananda Murtaye Nishprapanchaya. Om Namah Shivaya Gurave सच्चिदानंद मूर्ते निष्प्रपंच निष्प्रपंचाय शांताय निरालंबाय तेजसे तुम ही विष्णु विरिंजिस्तुम तुम च देवो महेश्वरः तुमेव शक्ति रूपासि निर्गुणस्तम सनातन यु आर द विष्णु आर परवेडिंग विष्णु यू आर द ब्रह्मन हु इज बिहाइंड द क्रिएशन यू आर द सुप्रीम देवा यू आर द लॉर्ड ऑफ ऑल ग्रेट यू आर द एम्बॉडीमेंट ऑफ पावर बिगर एंड यू आर विदाउट क्वालिटी यू आर इटर्नल So, such a great concept which I have felt inwardly. I have tried to present briefly. I stated even Saraswati Sharada will not be able to do justice if she go on writing, taking the cell, what you call the water from the ocean. For eternity. That is the greatness of Guru. That is the indefinable, universal, unmanifested Guru or Tattva. To that, we have to march little by little. We have to take the first step with the prayer Asato Ma Sadgamaya. तमसो मा ज्योतिर्गमय मृत्योर्मा अमृतमगमय इन हिडन मीनिंग इज यू लीड मी द इटर्निटी टू द इटर्नल ट्रूथ असतो मा सद्गमय तमसो मा ज्योतिर्गमय लीड मी काइंडली टू द वाइट लाइट द लाइट व्हिच ऑलवेज ब्राइटन्स व्हिच नेवर डिमिनिशेस मृत्योर्मा अमृतमगमय From the ephemeral world of pairs and opposites, do's and don'ts, life and death, being and becoming, take me to the eternal being, one with you. Asato ma sadgamaya, tamaso ma jyotirgamaya, mrityo ma amrutamgamaya. Sarve vai sukhina sandhu, sarve sandhu niramaya, sarve bhadrani pashyantu, na kaschid dukha bhavate. गुरुस्तम 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 जय जय गुरुस्तम गुरु नमस्कार सो थैंक यू फॉर केयर लिसनिंग विद पेशेंस
क्वालिटी ऑफ गुरुज वी हैव लर्न मेनी थिंग्स फ्रॉम योर वैल्यूएबल स्पीच गुरु गिव्स अस गाइडेंस फॉर चित चित आनंद 24 गीताज इन महाभारत gives us total picture of reality of gurus and many many things we have learned from you thank you very much and I hope near future also we will learn many things from you thank you very much
thank you
now priya
yes
can you sing by audio again will you try
yes I will try again
okay.
but
yeah
Yeah.
यत्पदं दर्शितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः अज्ञानतिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजनशलाघया अज्ञानतिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजनशलाघया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। ॐ शान्ति। ॐ शान्ति। So you are on the spiritual path. You are finding certain difficulties. Churasya dhara duratteya. Spiritual life is not an easy life, sir. We are all existing. We try to live. Then we have to reasonably live. Then we have to live a good life. Then we have to lead a virtuous life. Then we have to think of spiritual life. And then we have to start spiritual living. So these are different stages in living. We don't know where we are. Each man has to find out. If the earnest desire is inside, something in will propel you and you will come back to the Guru. Definitely. As far as I am concerned, the presence of a Guru, even though occasionally in in his physical form, may be of great help. Unless we are reached that stage, where we can receive this message, what you call beyond the indriyas.
Thank you so much, sir. It was a very profound reply. Maybe I have to do a little more nididhyasam, mananam, to understand the concepts which you explained. But so nice of you. Your explanations are so explicit and I am able to understand, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Anyone else? Like to ask question? Sindhi, sir, you like to say something?
No, I would like to appreciate Harihar Raghavan. Even I see very nicely he has explained, he has chanted nicely, created very good atmosphere. Yes. Very much thankful for him. And whatever question was asked, question was also very good. We theosophists believe in our higher self as the Guru. And in the other word, Guru inspires and teacher teaches. So what is it that inspires? Even nature also inspires with its visible language. And our love or bhakti also inspires us. It is said, hint comes from within, light comes from within. So within, this inspiration comes. Whoever inspires, we suppose him, we are grateful for him, and we consider him as the Guru. And it is a good thing to have gratefulness, gratitude to such people who are actually inspire us. So it is said, Lao Tse said long back, that when the disciple is ready, Guru will appear. This Guru is nothing but this inspiring, either it is visible or invisible, the hints they come. So we believe in such kind of inspiration, and humanity itself is our Guru. So we serve humanity. That is our first sentence of our mission. This humanity is the potentiality. Realizing that potentiality, which gives us hint, is our way. Maybe it a middle path, moderation, all our activities. So all this we believe as the member of the Theosophical Society, and Harihar Raghavan made it very, very clear, no doubt. So we believe in such kind of Guru, either visible or invisible. There are many who inspire us. Example, Radha Barnier was there, J. Krishnamurti was there. So all they have inspired us. And that inspiration, we express our gratitude to them and we consider them as our Guru. Because unless we prepared ourselves, how they can come in contact with us? So whenever you prepare yourself, they will come and give you inspiration. So seek the inspiration this way and follow that one. That's what I understood. And I thank Hariya Raghavan to give such kind of inspiring thoughts. Thank you.
Thank you, Shindeji, for your kind words. Whatever little bit I knew, I expounded that sorrow.
Thank you, sir. Mahapatra, sir, you want to say something?
No, conclude.
Then I think it's time for closing. I am really indebted to Indian section for giving me this opportunity to chair this session, for which I am not at all fit. Thank you very much, all of you, for listening to this session and inspire us. Thank you very much. Now we close the session. Thank you.
Thank you for attending the program organized by the Indian section. So we are going to close this link with the announcement that on coming Sunday, that is 14th, we will have no program because we are organizing, coordinating with the national conference organized by the Bihar Theosophical Federation. Yes.
Thank you.
I am going to close this link. Thank you for attending this online program of Indian section. Have a nice day. With these words, thank you very much.
Thanks to Pradeep for organizing. Thanks.
Thank you, sir.